cutting the ray lines. First cut is made, and this one is about five and six centimeters, five up and six. And then I have the second ray line, which is 14, and this one is measured from in between here up to here. So this is material that will be taken away now. And then reshaping here, coming to the end. Right now it looks like a kind of pointy, but this one will be rounded off. And also here it goes up a little bit since the nose is thinner, so you will have a nice curvature here. It looks really fat at the moment, but this one will come down quite substantially now in the next parts here. This is how I now rough cut the tail how I want it. This is very rough now. But now I have taken the first two cuts. And now it's time to see, do I like this, the lines? Do I have a nice flow of the lines over the board? How is the thickness of the board? Is it too thick? Is it too... Do I have the volume where I want it to have, where I want to have it? Or should I go and make another ray line here? Take it from half here and one more in here. And that's, I haven't decided that yet. We'll see how I feel now when I look at it and get the feel for it. So this is really then now the cut, the ray lines are done, the two main ones. Now it's more of, if I keep it like this, then I have to blend this one in. I will blend this one in and I will make it nice and round. And I will also do the same now going on the bottom curve. So I will do another ray line here that goes in underneath the board. And then when that one is done, it's about 1 centimeter in. So you get a nice, you want to have it round, I want to have it rounded. The edges in the front and sharp in the tail, sharp to get it to be a fast board where the water releases easy from the board. When it's rounded, the water will curve around the edges, but if it's very sharp here, it will release it, so you'll get a faster board. But you can't have it too much of a sharp rail all the way up, because then you will get caught, especially in freestyle. So you want to have some rounded rails up here in the nose. At least I want to have that. So I'm gonna have a sharp up to here, in more or less in between the foot straps, or a little bit or closer to the front foot strap, with a sharp rail. And then this one will be blended over into a soft rail in the front. The bottom shape now is pretty much done. Might go over this a touch also now before I do the first lamination. or the bottom, but it feels pretty nice as it looks right now. Normally I do the bottom rail shape after I've done, I put on the sandwich, the first layer of the sandwich, because then you can do it including the sandwich, so you get a nice sharp edge in the end and a really nice rounded one here in the front. So actually I could just go ahead now and laminate the bottom part, but I will have it thinking a little bit more on this one here first. We check how many liters this is at the moment. Very fancy weighing equipment we have here at Luma Board Factory. This is now 2.1 kilos. So at the moment, this is 105 liters. And that's too much, but that will come off now when I blend it, this one in. Just to get a feeling for it, I made from one of my old boards, I've done some rail shapes, not necessarily that I want to use one of these ones, but it's a good one to get a feeling for how the shape will be, and if it's even on each side. So this is 110 more or less. We can see I'm not that far off getting that one down. I have a pretty good, when I blend that shape in, it's not that far off actually. So that one, it looks really good actually. I might go with it, with this shape. We'll see. Just making the surface really smooth and flat. A lot of people use spackle to fill in the small, because this is beads, quite big beads, you will get a lot of cavities in the board. I really don't like to use spackle. I've tried it and I'm not feeling comfortable with it. I don't think it bonds any better than without it. Some people use epoxy, or thickened epoxy as a spackle, but for me the epoxy, it just soaks into this to the foam, and it makes the foam hard, yes, but it's still going to be builds weight, and that's what I don't like. And as long as I don't have a delaminated board, I'm going to continue to use my method. It's just making this quite smooth with a fine coarse sandpaper here, and then just go with a normal fiberglass and epoxy. But that I will do on a table on the side. We'll see.